The Giant Magellan Telescope will be the first telescope to detect Earth-like planets around distant stars. And we're going to learn more about this telescope starting right now. Hi everyone, my name is Christian Reddy. I'm an astronomer and I love to talk about this stuff. So, if you are here for the first time, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring that notification bell icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. The Giant Magellan Telescope, or GMT as it's called, is one of the next generation of extremely large telescopes that are currently under development. When it begins operations in 2023, it will be the largest telescope we've ever constructed, and it'll be the first to image Earth-like planets around distant stars. But let's talk a little bit about its unique design. Giant telescopes like the Keck telescopes combine relatively small mirrors to make giant 10-meter apertures. But breakthroughs in mirror technology developed at the University of Arizona allows mirrors even larger than 8 meters to be created. In a previous video, I talked about the Large Synoptic Survey Telescope. It's going to use an 8.4-meter mirror. That will make LSST the largest single-mirrored telescope ever built. But GMT will take a giant leap forward by combining 7 of these giant mirrors to create an enormous 25-meter mirror. That's more than double the size of the largest telescopes in the world today. But just having a large mirror isn't enough. Astronomical objects are faint, and their photons are few and far between. That means the mirrors have to be perfectly shaped and aligned so they can collect those photons and bring them to a focus. Any imperfection, or even the tiniest misalignment, must be smaller than the wavelength of light itself. The mirrors are built at the Richard F. Karas Mirror Lab at the University of Arizona. A special low-expansion borosilicate glass is placed into a honeycomb mold. The glass and mold are then enclosed in an electric oven. The glass is heated to 1200 degrees Celsius and melts into the mold. While the glass is molten, the furnace spins to give the glass its desired parabolic shape. The glass is then cooled very slowly at a rate of 3 degrees Celsius every day over a 3-month period. Afterward, the glass and mold are removed, the mirror is turned upright, and the mold material is cleaned out, and the result is a mirror that is 80% hollow and weighs a mere 20 tons. The mirror is then ground and polished to within 1/20th of the wavelength of light. In other words, if just one of these mirrors were enlarged to the size of the United States, its largest imperfection would be less than a 1/2 inch tall. Incidentally, the outer mirrors are off the optical axis, so the inner edge of each mirror has to be a little thinner than its outer edge, kind of like a giant glass potato chip. After polishing, an ultra-thin layer of aluminum is applied, and by ultra-thin, I mean just a few atoms thick. Each mirror takes about 4 years to manufacture. The telescope will use 7 mirrors. An 8th will act as a spare to be used whenever one of the mirrors are being cleaned. But even under the clearest of skies, telescopes have to contend with the distorting effects of the Earth's atmosphere. This is a phenomenon called astronomical seeing, and it's the reason we send telescopes like Hubble into space. But a telescope as large as GMT isn't going to find its way into space anytime soon. But it does have a really cool trick up its sleeve. Its secondary mirrors are thin and have actuators that warp and deform them to correct for the effects of the atmosphere in real time. This is called adaptive optics, and GMT will have the most advanced adaptive optics system ever developed. Will it work? Well, let's imagine looking at a crowded star field under ideal seeing conditions somewhere in the near infrared part of the spectrum. At this magnification, the stars are just blobs of light. The Hubble Space Telescope, with its 2.4-meter mirror, easily resolves the brightest of these stars, and the James Webb Space Telescope, with an even larger mirror, will be able to resolve some of the fainter stars. But the Giant Magellan Telescope, with its large aperture and adaptive optics, will resolve all the way down to its own diffraction limit. With that kind of resolution, GMT will be able to investigate questions that astronomers have been asking for a very long time, not the least of which is, are we alone? GMT will be able to detect planets that are more than 1 million times fainter than their host stars. We can do this today with our current telescopes, but so far we're limited to planets that are larger than Jupiter orbiting their host stars much farther away than Pluto does from the Sun. GMT, however, will be able to detect planets that are far closer to their stars, maybe even as close as Earth is from the Sun. GMT will be able to look at these planets' rotation, measure their masses, and even study their atmospheres to see if they are capable of supporting life. And that's just one of the questions GMT is designed to answer. It will also probe black holes, understand how they work, and watch what happens as they destroy stars that wander a little bit close. Or peer into the cores of distant galaxies and watch matter falling into the supermassive black holes at their center, creating quasars. GMT will be able to help us better understand how stars form, and even watch planets forming inside their planetary disks. But the best thing about GMT is that it won't be alone. It will work in concert with the next generation telescopes like James Webb, WFIRST, the 30-meter telescope, and the European Extremely Large Telescope. If you'd like to learn more about these telescopes, I have some videos about them right here on this channel, and I'll link to them in the description below. In the meantime, I'd like to hear from you. What are you hoping we can learn about with the Giant Magellan Telescope? What other upcoming telescopes or astronomical missions are you excited about? Leave a comment below and I'll be sure to check it out. And if you like this kind of stuff, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. Until next time, thanks for watching and keep watching the skies.